Thank you for joining me for another video from Grow and Give, a modern victory garden project brought to you by CSU Extension. Grow and Give videos will help you learn to grow food, share the harvest, and keep it local. In this video about berries for the Colorado garden, we're going to learn about blueberries. The following video is an excerpt from a live webinar on growing small fruits in Colorado. You can find the full webinar on the Grow and Give website.
Blueberries, a lot of people consider them like the holy grail of small fruit. And I think that must be a Colorado thing because they're so hard to grow here. people here really want to grow blueberries, but there's a lot of things we have to consider. The main thing is our soil pH and our soil alkalinity. We have high pH soils, high alkalinity, and that's just not what blueberries prefer. They also don't like to be in super heavy clay or even sandy soils. They really like a nice, rich, loamy soil. Again, something that we just don't find a lot here in Colorado. They also take a lot of water. They're definitely not a xeric type of fruit. And so our arid climate tends to dry them out a lot. And then we get hit with those cold temperatures in the winter and those big fluctuations and, you know, you name it, everything is kind of working against us when it comes to growing blueberries. So, again, very difficult to grow here. If you do try to grow blueberries, this is not a set it and forget it type of plant. You really have to commit to making that growing, those growing conditions perfect for that plant. And never will you ever grow blueberries in native soil in Colorado. Now, I know there's probably somebody out there who's going to challenge me on this and say, I have a blueberry bush growing in my backyard and it's doing just fine. But my question to you would be, how much fruit do you really get off of that bush? Because chances are it's just not going to be happy enough to be a big producer. I'm not going to say it's 100%, but it's pretty good bet. This picture was taken in Virginia. I think this is from one of their extension services there. And you can see that even in Virginia, where they have the perfect soil for blueberries, they're still using a lot of soil amendment to make them happy. So if you do want to try to grow blueberries in Colorado, you have to grow them in an acidic substrate like peat moss. So in the picture here, you can see this is what we call a peat moss bale. It's usually several bags of peat moss like you would typically buy at the hardware store, but they're compressed. So it's a compressed bale of peat moss. You need to keep that root zone very moist all year long, even through the winter. And it's not going to be easy because you're going to be moving these probably inside in the winter as well, because that is not planted in the ground. And so you're going to end up having your root zone frozen if you leave that out. You also have to protect the top of the shrubs from wind so they don't dry out. You can wrap them with burlap. You can put sheets over them during the dormant period. But again, if you're gonna leave them outside, you need to actually plant that peat moss bale in the ground so the root system doesn't freeze. And then you can't just do this with one plant. You actually need two different varieties for good cross-pollination. And I didn't mention it before, but there are also different types of blueberries. There's high bush blueberries, low bush blueberries, and rabbit eye. Here in Colorado, if you're going to try this, I would choose a high bush blueberry. Those are the types we also grew in Kentucky. They're just a little bit more winter hardy. The low bush are what come from Maine, and they're actually tiny little blueberries compared to the high bush, which are pretty good size, maybe the size of a dime or even a nickel or more. So are blueberries really practical? It depends on who you ask, but I would not recommend these for the beginning gardener. It's probably going to be cheaper for you to be like Allison and go buy your fruit at Costco or wherever you shop for your groceries when they're on sale. The plants don't produce high volumes of fruit if they fruit when they're grown in containers like this or when they're grown in the peat bales. Again, they're not water wise, and water is something we're concerned about here in Colorado. So essentially, you'd be growing your blueberries in a container like this if you were going to do that. So, and then think long term, you know, eventually that root system is going to outgrow that container. You'll get circling roots, and then you'll have stressed plants. So there are other small fruits that are easier to grow than blueberries. They need less water, less maintenance, and can be just as satisfying. And so in the next section, we'll look at currants, gooseberries, and grapes. I also wanted to mention service berries. Those are great ornamental plants that you can also harvest for fruit. A good one is Saskatoon, and that's what's in the picture that you see in front of you.
CSU Extension has some great resources to help you grow small fruits in Colorado. Be sure to check out our Master Gardener webpage. There you'll find lots of information about many different types of small fruits all in one place. Also, look for our Plant Talk articles. These are short and to the point. We also offer CSU Extension fact sheets, which are going to give you just a little bit more information. And if you really want to take a deep dive into growing small fruits, check out our Master Gardener garden notes. Thank you for joining me for this video. If you have more questions, contact your local CSU Extension office or check out our website at extension.colostate.edu.